leaf modifications. Leaf modifications, what is the first one? Tendril. Right? So, second one is the spines. Third one is storage leaves. Storage leaves. Fourth one is phyllodes. Fifth one is insectivorous leaves. Insectivorous leaves. Sixth one is reproductive leaves. Reproductive leaves. First one is the tendril. Tendril, I am also explained before, tendril means a small, delicate, sensitive structures. They are used for climbing purpose to the plant. That is known as a tendril. Okay. So, example in pea plant. So, in pea plant, generally, it is at compound leaf. Compound leaf means they are producing of that leaflets. So, these are the leaflets. Terminal leaflets are converted into tendril. These are the tendril. Terminal leaflets are converted into the tendril. Example, pea plant. Okay. Tendrils are small. It means thin, delicate, smooth structures are known as the tendril. So, they are the sensitive structures. They are used for climbing purpose to the plant. So, in this terminal leaflets are converted into tendril in pea plant. So, after then spines. So, spines means, for example, in cocti. So, cocti means, generally the scientific name is that vapansia. In that vapansia, leaves are converted into that, okay? So, sharp pointed like structures, they are known as the spines. For reducing transpiration. Okay, generally these plants are grown in drought condition for the loss of, for that prevention of that loss of water from the plant. Then leaves are converted into that spines for reduce the transpiration. Then stem is modified into leaf-like structure performing photosynthesis. It is also known that, flattened phylloclade, example, cocti spines. Storage leaves, I am also explained to you before. Succulent scale leaves are stores food material in bulb, example, onion. In onion, succulent leaf base. Succulent leaf base stores food material in onion. Right, phyllodes. Phyllodes, example, Australian acacia. Australian acacia plant. Right? So, in Australian acacia plant, at that younger stage, generally, so, they are that compound leaves. Generally, they are, it is a pinnately compound leaf. Pinnate compound leaf, generally. Right? Generally, it is a pinnately compound leaf. It is a pinnately compound leaf. So, it is a rachis. At that younger condition, it is a pinnately compound leaves. At the mature condition, these leaflets are falls off. Only which one is present? Only it is at a petiole. Only petiole is present. Only petiole is present. This petiole is expanded. So, green leaf lamina like structure performing photosynthesis. So, that is known as the phyllode. That is known as the phyllode. It means petiole is modified into leaf-like structure performing photosynthesis. So, that is known as that phyllode. Example, Australian acacia. After then, insectivorous plant. In some plants, generally, so, leaves are trapped that insects. Okay? So, for nitrogen material, for absorbing nitrogen material, it means, for example, Nepenthes plant. Generally, it is grown in nitrogen deficiency soil. So, Nepenthes grown in Assam forest region, in this nitrogen is very less inside the soil. For absorbing nitrogenous substances, then, so Nepenthes, in this Nepenthes, leaves are converted into that trap-like structure to catch that insects for requirement of nitrogenous substances. So they are known as that insectivorous leaves. Example, Nepenthes. Nepenthes. For example, so what is the diagram of that Nepenthes? In diagram of the Nepenthes, generally complete leaf is converted into the trap that insects or catch that insects. So these are the part of leaf. Generally it is stored, it is a petiole. It is at the lower part of petiole. It is known as upper part of petiole. It is known as a leaf lamina. It is known as a lid. It means it is a leaf apex. Leaf apex is converted into that lid. Lid means cap. Just like that lid. Leaf lamina is pitcher. Pitcher means what is the meaning? It is a flask shaped body. Pitcher means what is the meaning? It is at a flask shaped body. Next. So, leaf, lower part of petiole is converted into that wing like structure performing photosynthesis fill load. It is nothing but objective bit. It is also known as that fill load. So, upper part of petiole is known as that tendril, modification of leaf, tendril. Next, leaf lamina is converted into the pitcher to trap that insects. Leaf apex is the lid. Okay? So, inside that, okay, nectar glands are present and also proteolytic enzymes. So, when the insects are attracted by that attractiveness of lid, then it is reached to that, okay? So it means lamina or pitcher enter inside. So after that, this insect is slipped down, okay, fell down inside that slippery surface. So by the proteolytic enzymes, insects are digested. So after that, this plant absorbing nitrogenous substances. So that is known as that Nepenthes. Nepenthes, generally it is grown in Assam forest region. Another plant is also there, Dionea. It is at a special name, Venus flytrap. Okay. Second one is the Dionea. First one is that Nepenthes. Third one is Utricularia. Special name is known as the bladderwort. Right? It is a third. So after that, fourth one, Drosera. It is special name is known as that sundew. It means four types of insectivorous plants. First one is the Nepenthes. Second one is the Dionea. Special name is Venus flytrap. Third one is the Utricularia, hydrophytic plant. Special name is known as the bladderwort, Drosera, sundew. Four types of insectivorous plants are, okay, so catch that insects or trap that insects for nitrogenous protein material. So it is known as that, okay, insectivorous plants.